Welcome to Trading Nation. I'm Sara Eisen. We are joined by Wharton Finance Professor Jeremy Siegel. Always good to have you, Professor.
Thanks. Happy to be here,
So
Sara.
We know you as a long-term bull on U.S. stocks.
Yes.
What's your level of bullish feeling right now about this market?
I'm pretty neutral. Last December, I said, you know, this market's going to struggle this year after a great year in 17. I predicted 0 to 10%, and honestly, I don't see any reason to change that prediction. It's going to be a flat to slightly upward tilting year as good earnings collide with what I think is going to be higher interest rates, both by the Fed and in the Treasury market.
Throw into that mix a potential for a trade war. Does that change your thinking at all?
There's a potential there. Actually, I think political challenges in November for the Republicans holding the House is actually going to be a more important cautionary situation, because then it'll be much harder for the Republicans' agenda. I mean, what's left of it? I mean, the centerpiece is done, the corporate tax cut, but extending the personal tax cuts, the infrastructure, several other issues, it looks less and less likely that those will get done. And I think, you know, certainly the polls and the betting markets are saying it's going to be very hard for the Republicans to hold the House. So I think actually that is more of a threat than the trade war is for the market. I think things have been arranged between China and the U.S. I don't think Xi wants a trade war. I really don't think Trump wants it. He obviously likes a good market and knows they're sensitive. So he wants to get some victories in here and he'll try to push it that way. I'm getting more encouraged actually on the trade front than I was earlier this year.
I'm curious for you to elaborate on what you just said about the midterm election. So if the Democrats take the House of Representatives, is that a turning point for this market?
Well, not really, because again, the most important thing is a corporate tax cut, and that is permanent. But any, you know, what further legislation might be pro-business, honestly, I think is going to be put on hold over the next 2 years. In fact, I think it's put on hold now because, you know, it's a thin margin. The Democrats are just saying, hey, I'm going to win the House if I just stone face any of Trump's proposals. That may be right, may be wrong. But nonetheless, I think we're really going to have a stalemate. I don't think we're having an infrastructure plan. I don't think we're going to have a lot of progress on the deficit. Long-run deficit, as you know, is a threat. And the supply of treasuries, not only because of the deficit on the government's books, but also the Fed selling $200 to $300 billion worth of treasuries. This will pressure the market. 3.25% on the 10-year is going to give stocks a pause for 2018.
And we're at about 282 right now on the 10-year.
Right.
You mentioned it was sort of this collision between good earnings and rising interest rates. How much longer are earnings going to come in good? We're looking at another quarter of, what, 20% growth, even some revenue growth. But how long does that last?
Well, this year is going to be great, year-over-year comparisons, because of the corporate tax cut. But we also have to understand that this corporate tax cut is front-loaded. In other words, it allows expensing of capital equipment. That means firms are actually going to lose depreciation deductions in future years. So it's going to be great in 2018. 2019, you're going to have a growing economy to generate earnings gain. It's not going to be anywhere near as easy as it was this year.
So 2019, are you already looking ahead to stock returns then? Is it going to be a tougher year even than this one?
Yeah, I mean, I think you're not. I see earnings gains of 10% on some books for 2019. I think it looks more like 5%. And by the way, we're running a very hot economy. The Fed has to slow down job growth down from the current 200,000 average down to 100,000, or they're going to have to tighten much more. You know, this is all predicated on what we call soft landing, that the Fed could provide just enough pressure to get the job market to just the right temperature. That's not going to be easy either. Another challenge to the market. Again, I'm not predicting a bear market. Valuations are still very attractive for long-term investors. We're selling around 18 times this year's earnings. So I wouldn't sell out there. But these gains that people are talking about, 10 to 15% a year this year and maybe next year, I just don't think they're going to be realized.
Yeah, easy money is coming to a close from the Fed and potentially for the market. Jeremy Siegel, thank you. Always good to talk to you.
Thanks for having me.
All right, and thank you all for watching Trading Nation. I'm Sara Eisen. We'll see you next time.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.